Benin, so you guys don't feel like this guy is naked. So now we're going to go straight into this tutorial. My brushes, oh my god, I just want to create a collection with my brushes, but it's not coming through. The other day, and I was trying to change my foundation. I was using the Fenty Beauty foundation. If you guys know, you know I've been using the Fenty Beauty foundation. So I went to NYX to go try this Can't Stop Won't Stop by a YouTuber. I just can't remember her name. So I actually got her foundation and with the concealer. So I got this foundation and this concealer. Be spraying my face using this Bio Face Mist, like it's an hydrating moisturizer. So when I got this one this morning, I was like, I just want to try it. The foundation first. So when I went to NYX, I was trying to look for this foundation. I'll just leave it to like dry. I was trying to look for this foundation and the lady, like the makeup artist, was like, this foundation will be better for your skin type because I have a very oily skin. So she was like, this one is going to be good for you, just try it. So I was like, okay, I think she's right. Thinking that is from a YouTuber, I've watched so many reviews about this foundation. I was like, okay, let me give it a try. I think it's not gonna be that bad. So I got it and I got the concealer with it. I was supposed to buy the powder, but I took the NYX. I don't know where I kept it. This one, like a normal NYX powder, it using this brush. So when I buy foundation, sometimes I just start using it like after 6 hours, like because I work and I'm a hair stylist, so basically I work with heat. So after like let's say 6 hours, I begin to get oily. I have oil all over my face because of my foundation and I don't really like it. So the first day I used this foundation, I noticed that nothing changed in my makeup, like it stayed matte, like it didn't, like, the foundation did not shake. And I was like, considering the amount I used to buy this foundation, the first foundation I'll be using, that throughout the day my makeup did not move. I was super impressed and I was so happy with it. I don't know, I was just so happy. So now I'm going to go using the Can't Stop Won't Stop concealer, and this concealer also is a bae. So that's not what we'll be talking in this video. You guys, my birthday is coming. Can I get a birthday in advance? So I think this video is going to come out my birthday or probably a day before. I don't know, because I think I'm going to start editing it once I finish filming this. So my birthday is on the 12th of June, which means that this day is a very special day in my life, like very special to this girl. It's very special, it's a special day to me, like my birthday. So start, take a deep breath. So yeah, we are basically back. So I celebrate my birthdays, like I was trying to say that other years and this year birthday is not the same, because last year I didn't talk about my birthday that much, but this year I'm just so hype about it. I don't know if it's my age, I don't know why, but I'm just so into my birthday this year, like several my past birthday. Even my mom have to ask me, like, what, like, you just so into this your birthday this year. And I was like, isn't it good? Because I don't celebrate my birthday that much. And sometimes I'm like, I'm going to celebrate my birthday now. After a week passed, it's not as if I don't really have the money, but I just can't. Like, I just can't celebrate my birthday. I don't know why. I don't know. But this year, I'm just so into my birthday. I already have my birthday dress. I think today I'm going to do a photo shoot for my birthday. But I'm just the only one at home, but I'm going to try to do a photo shoot on my birthday. So, I'm just so happy. That's the reason why I'm talking about my birthday. Because, you know, in life, every day is not the same. So I think maybe this year's birthday is different from all other birthdays I've been doing, because I don't talk about them that much. So that's the reason why, because every day is not the same. Every day is not Christmas the Nigerian say. Well, I'm thankful to God for keeping me up to this time, because so many young girls more beautiful than me, more talented, more hardworking, they are no more, and I'm still here talking about my birthday. Like, it's worth celebrating. So I'll be using this brush. So I'm going to set my makeup using this. Wow, my makeup, why are they dirty? Being an adult is not really easy. Like, there are so many stuffs you have to do by yourself, and sometimes there are some energy, because when you start getting old, different energy starts coming. Sometimes you feel weak, sometimes you feel like your mates, like your peers, like your friends, they are making it more than you. Sometimes you feel like you are doing nothing, even though you are working hard, you feel like it's not really that enough. Like back last year, I was really pressurized. There was a place where I was working, and basically I'm a hairstylist. So it's a lot I was trying to practice. The owner, like, yeah, we call it patron. The patron, like the chef. I don't know what they call it in English. I think I'll just insert it here. So, because in French we call it patron. So the lady was not like, in the beginning she was happy with me, and I'm going to tell you the reason why she changed. In the beginning she was happy with me, she loved me, because everybody felt like I was really beautiful. They're like, you're so pretty. So that was the reason why she actually liked me. She wanted me to work with her. Anybody that goes to her salon to start working, some, like most of the people that she had in her salon, they started earning money when they started working, training with her. So basically she felt like that was my case, that I've not been any money, because she is the one that will tell you to go open a bank account, feel like you are big enough to have a bank account and this shit. And people will be like, oh, I'm surprised. So I'm going to set the place I contoured. So they'll be like, oh, I'm surprised, oh, I'm not a big girl. So basically with her, she felt like if she's going to tell me that I should go and open my bank account, I'll be so like, oh, do you mean this? Like, how much am I going to be any, like my head be all over everywhere. So because I already have all my stuff, I had my thing going on already, I was just there to come learn what I'm here to learn. Basically, she felt really angry. She didn't like me because I have my stuff going, because I was earning money already if I started working in a salon. So she felt like, what are you trying to pull? And this is what I always say, don't ever belittle yourself because you want someone to actually accept you in their life or in their working place, because this actually happened in a working place. You have to go put the bank account, because I need your bank details before that I can start paying you. I'm like, I already have a bank account. I think I'm going to just give you my account number so you can be paying me there. So she said, asking me like, you work already? I'm like, yes, I work every holidays. I work The moment I told her that I work already, this woman, her mood changed. And that was when I noticed that everything changed about her. So she felt really bad. And I was like, why are you feeling bad? Because I told you that I'm working. So from right from that day, she stopped talking to me. If I do anything, she'd be like, she was just so mad at me. And I was to train with this in this salon for like a year. 3 months, I was tired. That was among the reasons why I could not celebrate my birthday last year. Because this lady took hell out of my life. Oh my god, like anytime I remember this part, like whenever I remember it, I feel so bad. Today I don't even know the kind of how we are going to be doing, because I'm talking in this video. I'm just trying to make someone be motivated. Don't belittle yourself or anybody. Don't think you are not enough. Don't think what you are doing is not right. Someone else is doing it more better than you. I agree, we all don't have the same qualities. What I can do is not what you can do. That's why we all are different. But don't ever belittle yourself. Don't ever take yourself down to be accepted by people, because people, believe it or not, we all need each other in this life. If I have a business, I need you to come buy it. I need you to come buy my stuff. That we all, everybody is important in this life. Just like money is important. Don't ever feel like there is something you are not doing. You are doing it, the other people are doing it more better than you. Don't ever feel that way. To use this powder to set my face. So they're just thinking, like, she was like, she just feel intimidated. I think I'll use the word intimidated by my presence in her salon, thinking that I can't belittle myself for you just to like me. So I passed through a lot of hell in this salon. This video was not even for this salon, but I just want to tell somebody out there to do you. Just do you. This lady used me. She wanted me to go out of her salon because she felt like I was too much for her to handle. I got this cute palette from NYS and it's really cute. I think I'm going to try to use it for my transition. So for my transition, I'm going to be using this one first. Whatsoever I do, like even if I do, she didn't want me to touch to make customers' hair. And when customers tell her that they love what I did for them, like the hairstyle I did for them, she'll be so hungry. Like you see the hunger in her face, like she don't deserve to be like appreciated. She never want anybody to appreciate me. In that salon, clients always give me tips. Like there are sometimes I'll be dancing, because we have 2 floors, dancer and arm step. So there are sometimes when I make clients hair, when they are going, they will like tell her greet her for me. I'll just hear it down when I'm walking, and when I come up, she don't actually tell me, like she won't even bother to tell me that this client was great, so I should tell you bye. But if it's the other of my colleagues, she'll just tell them, and she won't add Maggie to what they said. Maggie, like, this means that she won't add her own words to just make everything sweet for to the person that she's trying to tell. She told me straight to my face that I'm not going to pass my exam. Like 4 months I was there, I was passing through depression. I was totally down. Like when you say that someone just going to go, like just to feel all righteousness sake, that was what I was doing. Let me just go and go work. Not as if I'm really enjoying what I was. Someone will say, like, you have a reason, like you would have left this place because you would have left the place because you were not accepted there. I wanted to leave there, but it was so late. Trying to get another contract would be really, really difficult, because all the salon, like all the contracts were closed. They were closed. So I didn't know what to do. I was like, should I just sit down at home, just stop it? Next year, I'll just just register for another full year. What am I going to do? Because this woman was, she was just driving me motivated anymore. I was not motivated. I never felt like, but there's only one thing I love about myself. Even though when this period was really difficult for me, I always stand up from my bed and go to work. I never sat down any day. Even though I feel like, even though I had them, when I was having panic issues, like if I start, there was some situation where I would start breathing fast. Sometimes I don't even feel my breath. And even though I had all those, I had to go to a salon. Like, I have to go work, I have to go do what I'm here to so do. There was this nice woman in that place, she was also learning like me. She was like, she saw me how I was, and she was just trying to talk to me that, don't worry, you are a fine girl, just try and just push through, and when you get what you are here to look for, you just leave the salon, don't stay, even if she wants to give you another contract, don't stay. I was just doing my stuff, just work as normal. Sometimes you just want me to come to work on intentionally, because that day I was not supposed to work. She just like come to work, come and work. I will still go do my stuffs. My god, like if I just start thinking about it, I'll just start feeling somehow, because people are really wicked. She was a white lady. For me, I feel like she's a racist. Like she's a racist. She don't like black. Took everything from this lady. I tried to be patient. It's going to be over very soon. You're going to write your exam and you're going to leave. And go somewhere else to go work. I never knew this, how much this lady hated me, until when I was, oh my god, like now I don't feel like sharing tears, because whenever I think about it and I think of how God actually brought me out of this situation, how God blessed me after this one, I just feel so fulfilled. That's the reason why I just want to celebrate my birthday this year, because last year was really difficult for me. Was really, really, really difficult. Like, I never knew how this lady hated me until when I was trying to do my exam. So she told one of the worker there, because this one was like, oh my god, this one was, she was close to me, so whatever this woman tell her, she come and tell me. So she was like, she told her that she's going to fail me for my exam, I'm not going to pass this exam. Oh my god. So when she told me that, she was like, go and try and work in other subjects. Try and work in other subjects, you know that you're going to pass. Try to get better notes in all other stuff, your subjects in school, because in school also you have to like style a model in our school, so that when you have to go and style your model in the school, try and work hard to get more than the points you have to get, because she told me that she's not going to pass you in your exam. I was so shocked. I never told my mom. I did not tell her, because I did not tell my mom. I was like, God, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Because my mom paid my school fees. She paid everything. And in the end of the term, I was telling her that, mom, I didn't make it. Oh my God. Thinking that you just come on hairdresser. Like Nigerians say, come on hairdresser and you need to pass your exam. Just about hair, you don't know where you put do the hair. So at that point I was so depressed and start panic and everything. Hospitalized in the hospital, I was hospitalized. They gave me oxygen, and my mom was actually crying. She was just crying. She was like, I don't know what my daughter is thinking, what she's thinking. She never knew that this was the reason why I was passing through all this. Because I heard she was not going to pass. I was trying to tell my school that I don't like this place they sent me to go learn. Like, I don't like this place. This lady is getting everything out of me. They were like, oh, she's really strict, but you just have to hold everything. Now, come, let me just do my eyeliner. My My school never saw reasons with me why I said I don't like her. So I had no choice than to just stay for that full year. I think that would be a different story, like it would be the part two. If you guys are really interested in several things that this lady did to me, just leave a comment. So it got to my exam day. So she finished the exam for me. And my school, they were not okay with it because I was the first person to start our exam. We were supposed to start doing our exam in our different salon the same time, but mine was the first because she wanted me to do my exam probably because she don't want them to give me a spoil about how everything should be done. So this is the new style I'm using. I just launched on my line and I'll be using it for this video. If you guys, this is the fifth time I'm using this lash and you guys can see it's still intact. It's really stay intact, so I'm going to be fixing it. So I'm using this glue, like it's a hair glue. My friend was supposed to be my model. Like you guys, if you want to have a friend, have a good friend. Now I don't have friends anymore because it's a waste of time. I've had friends that, even boyfriends, I've dated a guy. Like I'm not really lucky in that aspect, I've actually accepted it. I've had a friend, instead of a friend to be like be on my side, she was against me. Lashes are really difficult to fix. Like this one is really nice. So I just finished fixing my lashes and they are really cute. And yeah, go inside using this glitter. Really a good glitter. After everything, long story short, I did my exam. So I never put hope. There was no hope that this lady was going to make me pass, because not going to make me pass even though I passed. So I was not, there was no, I was not even having hope that maybe God would touch her mind. I was like, that one is out of the place, like that one is out of it. So I had to work in other areas, other subjects, which I know that I don't need her to, she's not there to like make me pass those ones. Did my best, leave the rest for God to do his own best. And all the results were supposed to like come on June, which was the month of my birthday last year. So I was like, if I don't get it, it was sure that I was not going to pass it. So I was like, let me just forget this birthday this year, because this year I'm not going to celebrate this birthday. Yeah, so when the results came out, everything came out. To go to a website to see if you passed your exam. So all my friends were like, I passed it. I started seeing notifications on Facebook. My friends were shouting, oh, I made it. And they asked me, won't you go and check yours? I was like, I can't go and check it. I know I had not passed it. So they were like, go and check. So I sent one of my classmates to go help me check it, if I actually made my exams. So they checked it and behold, baby girl passed it. So I passed it. And I was so excited. Like, I was super excited. I was like, God, finally you did this for me. I was so excited. I felt so good. And I was like, thank God this birthday was is going. And if I go into details of what I passed through in this place, you guys, you're going to start crying. Like I'm just everywhere saying like this and this and this. Like I know who's saying the story. We are not that these people that know how to say story. If they put this one in story, it's going to take like 3 hours. People will not go. When I got the results, when I got the notes of like they just send you the notes, like the grades you have in all the subjects. And they showed me hers. Guess what? She did not pass me. Instead of her to make like the cut mark was from 10 to 20. And she gave me 9. Okay, let's say that this girl had an issue. Like she gave me 9. So people would just had 1 mark to just pass this girl, but intentionally moved that 1 mark. And I was like, God, thank thank you that I never trusted. I never felt like this man is going to be the one that will make me pass. Thank God I worked hard to pass other subjects. It actually broke my heart though. I was like, so this woman actually meant what she said. Like, she meant it that I was not going to pass her subject. Like, she's not going to make me pass. But I thank God today that I got my certificate. I thank God that I passed it after all the struggles. And after God, that God opened a very good way for me. God blessed me. I got another contract from from a different salon, and I got a free like this time. I didn't have to pay any fees. Like, it was just 3 years free with good payment. Like, is this one not God? Today I'm working in a place where I enjoy working, and I'm thanking God for ordering my steps to that place. Like, thinking that your bed is going to solve all your problems, you don't have to see people. Just don't listen to your instinct, because inside you is going to tell you that don't go home, don't go and work, don't go out, don't go to that place, you don't like you, you don't have this, you don't have that. Take yourself low, don't do too much, don't belittle yourself or anybody, don't act stupid for anybody to think you don't have sense. Don't ever do that. Don't do that. Don't do, because people want you to do according to what they want you to do, not according to what you want to do. Don't do. I never gave up. Thank God today I'm enjoying what I never enjoyed in a place, and it's a part of life. It made me to learn something different from what, like, it made me to see life in a different way. And I won't lie, I also thank God for that, for me passing through that experience, because it made me to see life in a different way, and made me to be, to know that you have to push really, really hard to make things in life. Don't ever feel comfortable in a place where you are. Always strive to do more, always strive to be the best version of yourself, because the things you have not yet seen is in the front. Don't give up. I watched this video of one girl. She was talking the other day, and she was talking about push through and don't give up. You are the only one that knows what you want your future to be like. You are the only one that sees the picture of where you are going to. Even though you are going too slow, just make sure that you get to the place you want to be. I'm going to use my this powder to set all my makeup. I'm just going to be fast with this because I have somewhere going. I'm going to spray my face. My face is really tight. I'm going to spray my face. I think I'm going to spray this one first. I'm just going in using my blush. Next, I'm going to go into my highlight using this palette from NYX. I'm going to use this lip gloss. This girl is glowing. Yeah, I hope you guys like this look. Please, I'm begging. Whatsoever situation you find yourself, don't feel abandoned. Don't hate yourself, because sometimes these problems can taunt you to hate yourself. Feel like you're not worth it, like you're not doing like others. And just try and be true to yourself. Pray to God. Tell God to lead you to the right steps, and always try to be patient. Don't accept being weak don't accept being depressed.
See you guys in my next video. Bye bye. Mwah.